Today we are going to talk about Fibonacci series, and it is nothing but it is a series of numbers where the next term is the sum of previous two terms. So whenever you are constructing it, you need to have the previous two numbers. For example, so this is an example of Fibonacci series. So the first two numbers are fixed, that is 0 and 1, and the next term is sum of previous two terms. So 0 plus 1, it is 1. And similarly with the 2 and 3, that is for 2 it's 1 plus 1 2, and next it's 2 plus 1 it's 3. So let's try to write a program here. So let's initialize some values. So I'm considering A as the first value, so I'm taking it as 0, B as the second value, so 1, and C as the next value. So how many numbers you want in that series? So now we are going to write the main logic. So I'm using here for loop. You can write whatever condition you want. So let's remove this. So I'm first I'm printing the value of A, because you know the at the beginning we need to print the first value. So printf. So we have printed the value of A. So now we don't need the value of A, that is 0. Okay. And however, you know, for printing the next term, we need to have the previous two values. So I'm using A plus B so that the value will be stored in C, and A equal to B. So as we have used the A, right now we don't need that A value. And similarly, B is equal to C. And written some value here. I think everything is good. Okay, let's run it. Let's take it as 3. Yeah, 011. Okay. Let's run again. Say take 6. Okay, so let's try to trace the program. So initially the value of I is 0, and let us take it as 4, and A value is nothing but it's 0, and B value is 1. C. Okay. Okay. So initially, it will go into the loop, that is I is equal to 0, and it will print the value of A, that is 0. So initially, we are printing the value 0, and next, C is equal to nothing but A plus B. So now the value of C is nothing but 0 plus 1, that is 1. Okay, so the value of A is nothing but right now A is equal to B. Okay, so B is nothing but it's 1, so we are initializing A equal to 1, and B is nothing but it's C. So B equal to C, the value of C is nothing but it's 1, so it remains the same. And next it will go into a loop at I equal to 1. Okay, so at I equal to 1, again it print the value of A, so we'll get 1, and then C is equal to A plus B, so 1 plus 1 it's 2, and A is nothing but A equal to B. So B value is nothing but is 1, so it remains the same, and B is nothing but it's equal to C, so C value is 2. And next it will go into a loop at I equal to 2, so it will print the value of A. A value is nothing but is 1, so it's going to print 1. And next C is equal to A plus B, so A plus B is nothing but 1 plus 2, that is 3. And next A equal nothing but it's B, so A value will be 2. And B is nothing but it's C, so B value is nothing but 3. Okay, again it will go into the loop and I is equal to 3. And condition, we need to see the condition that 3 is less than 4, so it is true. So it will go into a loop and it will print the value of A. So what is the value of A right now? It's 2. It's 2. Okay, it has printed the value of 2, and C is equal to A plus B. 2 plus 3 is 5. And A is nothing but it's B, so it's 3, and B is nothing but C, so it's 5. And it will go into a loop. So now I will be 4. So 4 is less than 4, so the condition fails, and it will come out of the loop and print the values, that is 0, 1, 1, 2. So this is how we construct the Fibonacci series. Hope you guys have understood what the Fibonacci series is and how to construct it. So if you like the video, do subscribe and do share the video. Thank you.